Hello dear friends, this is the third in a series of videos about standards for constructing and equipping new healthcare facility. For more videos, please visit my Facebook page, Healthcare Quality, and my YouTube channel, Dr. Hassan Kamel. I'll be very happy to answer questions from your side. If you like it, please support me with likes and follows. In this video, we will talk about Critical Care Unit CCU standards. First, critical care general. Each unit shall comply with the following provisions. One, the location shall offer convenient access from the emergency, respiratory therapy, laboratory, radiology, surgery, and other essential departments and services. Second, each patient space shall have a minimum of 14 square meters of clear floor area with a minimum head wall width of 3.5 meters per bed, exclusive of anterooms, vestibules, toilet rooms, closets, lockers, wardrobes, and/or alcoves. If it's not possible to meet the above separate rooms or cubicles for single patient use, shall be no less than 12 square meters, and multiple bed space shall contain at least 10 square meters per bed. When private rooms or cubicles are provided, view panels to the corridor shall be required and shall have drapes or curtains which may be closed. Where only one door is provided to a bed space, it shall be at least 1.2 meters wide and arranged to minimize interference with movement of beds and large equipment. Sliding doors shall not have floor tracks and shall have hardware that minimizes jamming possibilities. Where sliding doors are used for access to cubicles within a suite, a one meter swinging door may also be provided for personnel communication. Four, each patient bed area shall have space at each bed sides for visitors, and provisions for visual privacy from causal observation by other patients and visitors. For both adult and pediatric units, there shall be a minimum of 2.5 meters between beds. Five, each patient bed shall have visual access other than skylights to the outside environment with not less than one outside window in each patient bed area. Six, systems for rapid and easy information exchange with the hospital are important. Seven, there shall be at least one hand washing fixture for each three beds in open plan areas and one in each patient room. 8. Administrative center or nurse station. There shall be direct or remote visual observation between the administrative center or nurse station and all patient beds in the critical care unit. 9. Medication station. It shall contain a work counter, cabinet for storage of supplies, sink with hot and cold water, refrigerator for pharmaceuticals, and double locked storage for controlled substances. Convenient access to hand washing facilities shall be provided. 10. The electrical, medical gas, heating, and air conditioning shall support the needs of the patients and the critical care team members under normal and emergency situations. 11. At least one infection isolation room shall be provided. 12. The following additional service space shall be immediately available within each critical care suite. These may be shared by more than one critical care unit, provided that direct access is available from each. 1. Securable closets or cabinet compartment for the personal effect of nursing personnel. 2. Clean workroom or clean supply room. 3. Clean linen storage. 4. Soiled workroom or soiled holding room. 5. Nourishment station. 6. Ice machine. And 7. An X-ray viewing facility. 13. The following shall be provided and may be located outside the unit if conveniently accessible. 1. A visitor's waiting room. 2. Adequate office space that permit consulting with members of the critical care team and visitors. 3. Staff lounge and toilets shall be located so that staff may be recalled quickly to the patient area in emergencies. 4. Special procedure room. 5. Sleeping and personal care accommodation for staff on 24-hour on-call work schedules. 6. Housekeeping room. And 7. Storage space for stretchers and wheelchairs. 2. Coronary care units. Each coronary care unit shall have a separate room for acoustical and visual privacy. It will have access to a toilet in the room. Portable commodes may be used in lieu of individual toilets, but provisions must be made for their storage, servicing, and odor control. Third, combined medical, surgical, and coronary care unit. At least 50% of beds must be located in private rooms or cubicles. Fourth, pediatric critical care. In addition to the standards previously listed for critical care units, each pediatric critical care unit shall include 1. Space at each bedside for parents, in addition to a sleeping space for parents who may be required to spend long hours with the patient. If the sleeping area is separate from the patient area, it must be in communication with the critical care unit staff. 2. Provisions for formula storage. These may be outside the pediatric critical care unit, but must be available for use at all times. 3. Separate storage cabinets or closets for toys and games for use by the pediatric patients. 4. Examination and treatment rooms. 5. New Pearl Intensive Care Unit. The NICU shall have a clearly identified entrance and reception area for families. The area shall permit visual observation and contact with all traffic entering the unit. A scrub area shall be provided at each public entrance to the patient care area. Two, at least one door to each room in the unit must be large enough to accommodate portable X-ray equipment. Both width and height must be considered. There should be efficient and controlled access to the unit from the labor and delivery area, the emergency room, or other refiller entry points. 4. Controlled casual viewing of infants. In the interest of noise control, sound attenuation shall be a design factor. 6. A central area shall serve as a control station, shall have space for counters and storage, and shall have convenient access to hand washing facilities. 7. Each patient care space shall contain a minimum of 9.3 square meters, excluding sinks and aisles. There shall be an aisle for circulation adjacent to each patient care space with a minimum of 1 meter. 8. An airborne infection isolation room is required in at least one level of nursery care. 9. Blood gas lab facilities should be immediately accessible. 10. Physicians' sleeping facilities with access to a toilet and shower shall be provided. If not contained within the unit itself, the area shall have a telephone or intercom connection to the patient care area. 11. Sleeping space may be needed for parents who may require to spend long hours with the neonates. 12. A respiratory therapy work area and storage room shall be provided. 13. A consultation, demonstration, breastfeeding or pump room shall be provided convention to the unit. 14. Medication station. 15. Clean supply room. 16. Soiled holding room. 17. Staff lounge, locker room, and toilet within or adjacent to the unit. 18. Emergency equipment storage, such as a CPR cart. 19. Housekeeping room. 20. Space should be provided for the following: 1. A visitor's waiting room. 2. Nurse's supervisor's office or station. Thank you.